Monster Mash, the graveyard smash. Who's doing the Monster Mash? What's up, you guys? Such a Boss here, and today I'll be doing a Halloween review for you guys. Today I'll be discussing the movie Happy Hubie Ween. It's a new Adam Sandler movie. It has Adam Sandler in it as Noah from Stranger Things. It is a really good movie overall. I think it's a mediocre film. It's okay. I got me in the spirit of Halloween. I love Adam Sandler. So I'll give you the whole plot right now. Pretty much opens up with this character named... what's his name again? Hubie? Hubie. His name is Hubie. Huey Dewey. So Huey Dewey loves Halloween to the point that he wants to make this whole town be safe because he lives in the Halloween capital of the world because it's a small town, obviously. And Adam Sandler pretty much goes on a quest to like save Halloween and make sure it's like a safe town. That's almost what the plot's about. And different things happen on the town. Like, for example, the different bullies have been like teasing him, and there's like this whole corn maze scene and this all sorts of stuff. There's also spoilers in this video. I forgot to mention that right now. Spoilers! So, let's talk about some of my favorite elements of the movie.
Things in the movie is the mom's, Hubie's
mom's t-shirts. It's really cool because, like, I really, really like all the princesses. One of them has a reference to Birds of Prey, which is, like, I shave my beeps for this. I can't say it on camera because it's PG-13. I'm sorry. It's a really bad saying. I can't really say it. It said, I blank blank for this. That's what it meant. I'm so sorry about that. And if I offended anybody. So, Hubie Halloween. It's pretty much a Halloween story. And it's really almost a coming
Sandler's
of age.
Sandler's character really likes eating soup. To the point he mixes like three different kinds of soup from his girlfriend's diner
into one bottle, and he put a little A1 sauce, and he puts on there. Also, talk about his thermos. His thermos is amazing. I just really like his thermos because his thermos literally has a little thing I like to call a little bit of a gadget. I don't know how he made it himself, but it just... It's very, very interesting how it works. He's like filled up his soup. Also, the mom is really funny. She has kind of like a main twist with like, she literally abducted like all the kids and attempted to kill them, all the bullies, which is kind of sad. But the mom's seizures are kind of ridiculous at times. She doesn't even know what it means. And like, one of these lines is kind of like the middle of the movie, where like, the maidens have a big mistake. It's a, can't say on a camera word, but it's in the movie. It's super funny, you gotta check it out, it's on Netflix, I think it's good for the family. I really appreciated that, honestly. I thought it was a very good movie, Hubie Halloween. One of things I didn't really like the police chief. He's kind of like weird at times, almost like a, not like mean, but like kind of like obnoxious in a way, his character. But I like his beard though, his beard's really cool, and he kept on talking about the Muppets. I don't understand if he's the actor for the Muppets. I don't really sure know what he did for Jim Henson, maybe it's just a joke. I can really tell, but it was very interesting, seriously, guys. Another thing about the movie I want to mention is, like, the different corn mazes, like, just different things, like that trick-or-treating. He remember just rides his bike everywhere, and I think it's really cool. It's really cool, honestly. Some things I wish it could be changed, and I felt like some of it was a little rushed. The plot seemed a little silly. One thing I did not like about Adam Sandler, he uses his same, like, Billy Madison voice for all of his roles, like, for his silly roles. I really feel like Adam Sandler should, like, skip that voice and make a new voice, something like that. But Adam Sandler's a talented actor, very funny man. He does a lot of funny things. He was in Grown Ups, like, my favorite role, obviously, is Billy Madison he portrayed. He did so many cool characters over the years. My final reason, I'm going to talk about Noah Shaft, and then I'm going to close the video. Noah Shaft, a.k.a. the guy from Stranger Things, he,
is there. He dresses up as a robot and he goes to a party and drinks black coffee, which I thought was kind of funny. I don't think he's a coffee drinker for some reason. Huh. That's kind of a fun fact. No Chef is a coffee drinker. Leave in the comments. I'm not sure. I don't drink coffee myself, but No Chef might. He's kind of funny. He acts like a normal like freshman. He's a freshman in high school. But really, I think he's a like, junior in high school. I think he's close to my age. And I'm not really sure what grade he is in. Maybe a senior. I'm not really sure. But Noah's Chaff is pretty funny. He's only in there for like four, like 3 minutes, and then at the end. One of the things I left on his Instagram for Hubie Halloween is, did he shave his head for the role? Because there's a scene where he dresses up as a priest and he's bald. I don't know if it's a bald cap, CGI. Leave in the comments. I can't really tell what the effect was. It was really neat. He's a really loving brother of his sister's, and there was also a scene on Rich Trial, kind of talking about it in the movie. It's really weird. Worst story arc in the story happens to be the werewolf story arc. I didn't really like that. It was funny. Not really. My favorite part of the story is when he mixes all the soups together, and also just trying to when he goes to school and he wears the ghost costume. I thought it was hilarious. It was really funny how he's kind of explaining the Halloween safety rules to the kids. I thought that was hilarious. That's my favorite part right there, and also the whole Cormay story arc. I love Cormay's. Other than that, I really give this film probably a solid 7 out of 10. It's funny. I feel like it's a typical Adam Sandler family comedy movie. I feel like it's perfect for Halloween. It really got me in the mood for trick-or-treating this year. I'm just very excited for Halloween. I can't go trick-or-treating this year, but I'm doing an advent calendar. Like, I did a video separate later for this, but I'm in the Halloween mood after watching Happy Halloween. There's a lot of, like, adult jokes in there. I recommend ages for a kid. I say 13 and up, guaranteed. If you let your 10-year-old watch it, I think. There are some minor words at home. It's a little profanity. I don't think the kid will understand some of the t-shirts the mom was wearing in the show. She's a really older lady. Obviously, she doesn't understand what the words mean. Some of the shirts are hilarious. Some of them I wish I could actually get. In person, I think she went thrift shopping or something and got all the shirts. Or the prop designer come up with it. I think it's hilarious. Well, one of my favorite t-shirts is the one from Birds of Prey, obviously. But I'm not even now. If you guys like and subscribe, such awesome more videos like this in the future. And thanks for watching. Peace.